Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I have a project share, and this is a gift for one of my sweet dear friends. And I've tried this video several times now, and I think I've got a virus in my device, but I'm gonna give it another try. So here we go. This little doily book is again going to one of my friends. It was made by using these little doilies, and I was showing you how you just attach them. I cut them this way, and then I attach them by threading a little, a little something, seam binding. In this case, I use seam binding. You just thread it through all these holes, and this is a really cool doily because they're really thick and sturdy, and then they have these holes all the way around, so it makes it really easy for you to bind them. So again, I just stuck the little lace through the holes. You can also layer them on top. I like to do it the other way, but you can layer them on top if you're not going to make them too thick. And super simple for the newbies to just, thread it through whatever you're going to use, your seam binding, your baker's twine, your lace, whatever. And you can thread it through all of these, and then you've got your little four pages, right, for your doily book. Again, I like to do it this way, lay them on top and then thread it this way. You could do however many pages, you want that way. And I still have lots of these available. I got a blanket at my yard sale quite some time ago, and I hadn't cut them all, but I've cut some more now. So I am selling these, and you can make, there's four here. So if you cut, like this, if you cut here, these four will make one four-page doily book, and then you have these four, and I am selling them two at a time for $10. That means you can make four of these doily books. One, two, three, four, and these are 4x4 squares, or you can use the entire piece, and again, you can just join it here. This is 8x8, and you can just make one big doily book like this and cover it up. So anyway, if you're interested, leave me your PayPal down below. US, I think this can ship for like $4.50, maybe $5. Actually, no, I'm gonna put it in a flat rate, so it'll be $6.60 or $6.75. I'm going to put it in a flat rate envelope for you. So US, and then for international, it'll be somewhere between $12 and $14, I think, or $12 and $16, depending on, where you are. And again, let me go ahead and just put your PayPal information down below, and I'll send you an invoice, and I'll have all that in the description box. Okay, so this is how I made this little book, as you can see. And then you just add the dangles, and it turns into a huge book. This one is, like I said, 4.5 by, I think it's 7 inches. Yeah, it's just about 7 inches there. Yeah, just about 7 inches. Anyway, so that's my book, and I used many of my goodies from all my friends, Bonnie and Mamie and Julie Deary and Nola Harris and Deb Hendrick and Bonnie Bird. I said Bonnie Bird, Gail. This is my own. This is my own. That's my own. Goodies of just layering goodies. This is my own doily from one of my blankets I had a long time ago. This one as well. I think this one's in my store, this doily. I just, used purple fabric and little baby doilies. That's from Michael's, I think. And then I put all of the bling. This one was left over from a scarf that I got at the dollar store, I think. And then this is a hairnet. My husband keeps bringing me these. He works in the meat department in Walmart. And when he goes to the bakery department, he brings these hairnets. So I just cut them. I cut the elastic off. And then I use the little, you know, the meshy thing. So that's that. And then just a piece of lace. I think this was shared with me by... it's either Deb Hendrick or it was June Angel Pews. She sent me this lace and it's got like sequins there you could see. But the sequins are on the other side, so that's why you can't see them there. And let me see. This was Nola. This was Nola. This is mine. This is mine in my store. This little lace here. And that, I think that was Nola. This one was Nola. This is mine. Just a little piece of ribbon, like the wire ribbon. And that was given to me by Gail. I put it on the top there like a headband. And this is just more of, oh, I don't have it. I thought it was here. It was like a scarf like this one, like a meshy scarf. Gail, that's one of my laces that I like. It's all bumpy that I dyed. Okay, let's go inside. It looks like my, knock on wood, where's wood? My camera's gonna stay on. Okay, so these are the images that I chose. Please focus, camera. There we go. And I did them in black and white and on satin materials, so they're not coming out really good in this light, but you can see her and you can see this older lady there. And I have again just scraps, lace scraps. This was a piece of mesh that I hand dyed. This lace here was from Olivia. She shared this with me a couple years ago. This is my fabric that I just gathered up and put some bling. This was from Debbie Vignola. This is from Gail, this blue piece here. And this was from Gail. This was edging, like a gathered piece of edging, and I just wrapped it up and turned it into a flower. This is some of my trim that I made. A little brown lace. Scraps, doily scraps. These are all just little bits and pieces of scraps. That's a lace that I had. Little heart lace. I cut out the hearts. This one was a curtain that I had found. This is some blue, really pretty blue velvet material that Debbie Hendrick shared with me. Yeah, just little bits. This is some of my blouse, more blue. I put this blue on the bottom, but I want you to be able to see the layers, so I made sure it's sticking out. You can see all the layers. This is in my store, and I just dyed it blue. This one is part of this. It was, like I say, it was a curtain. So, there's that. And then at this side, I have more Nola. This fabric was, this lace is my lace that I dyed. And this was given to me by Gail. This was given to me by Virginia, I think. Long time ago. This is my little sequin fabric, and this one was from Olivia. This is more of my sequin, this sequinsy fabric. I just kind of fashioned a bow. And then this one here is from Gail. She gave me a little like a 8-inch piece of trim, and I use it really sparingly because I love it. I wish I had more of this. So pretty. It's got beads. So I put a little bit there. This is just a corner piece, and this one I purchased from Alicia, who used to have a store, Glitz and More. And I put these little sequins in all of the little corners there, so you can see them. And then there is some more of this fabric that Gail gave me in the background there. So now you can see, let me do close-ups. You can see all the little bits that I did. And this one, all the little bits that I did. All the little, you can see all the layers. I like to make sure you can see all the layers. Okay, so there's that. And, no, this one, I was going to do a pocket and then I glued it down, so I've got to finish gluing that down. Okay, this is the flower page, and then, oh, I forgot, on this corner, I did a little bead. I'm not done with that yet. And then this is, more fringe that I got from, Gail. I turned it into a tassel, and it's being held by a garment pin there in the corner. There we go. And see that you can see the doily book down there. Okay, so I layered this piece of curtain. And then I layered, this is my little tulle fabric that I have. I bought that a long time ago. It's got little bumps and glitter. Little bits of glitter. I don't know that the light is going to catch the glitter. I don't think you can see the glitter. There we go. I don't know. It's not being glittery, but it's glitter. This is from one of my blouses. A little tassel that was shared with me by Bonnie, and she's SS Scrapper. Here, she was SS, or she still is, but she doesn't do videos anymore. SS Scrapper here on YouTube. And then I have little bits of sari, and I, this is a sari that I got from, eBay, and then little bits of blue fuzzy, and then this was from Mamie, and I thought, they're leaves, but I thought they looked like a wing, and then that's just a little teeny tiny piece of beaded trim that came from this flower here, and I put it, like, right here on the bottom. Some of my words on top of some pink fabric. This is another, this flower is layered on top of my flower, and I got that from Rosella. And then this is the blue that you see sticking out down here. I have this blue kind of really cool fabric there that this flower is laying on top. So we have this flower on this flower, then we have this flower on, it's getting stuck, on this lace, and then we have this lace on some orange lace, and this lace also was given to me by, I want to say, the orange one is, it's either Linda Green or Jonine. I forgot which one gave it to me. And then this is my dress, my gold dress. And this one is from my sweet friend, Judy Dominguez. And then more of the green fabric from Virginia. And then this is part of the lace, this lace here. I put the whole sheet down there. So layers, layers, layers there. Bunch and bunch of layers. And you can see them all. Judy Dominguez layer. You can see them all there. So that's my flower page. And then this one is of the next signature. And I have this piece of fabric that was given to me by Nola, and I just cut it up and I turned it into a, it's like a t-shirt material, but I turned it into a dangle. And then I had this little red dangle, and this one was given to me by Gail. And then this is the same flower here. It's a fabric that I have. So it that's there. And then this little flower is from this fabric here. And this actually, this fabric came to me from Trisha, Little Shabby Chic, when we did our Doily book swap. She sent me this fabric. So that's what these little bits are. This bit, and this bit. They're from a Little Shabby Chic. And then this was the dangle trim from Bonnie. And she is Sassy Scrapper again here on YouTube. And then these little tiny bits are from Nola. She gave me a black sari and it had these little teeny tiny bits. So I cut those off. This frame here is a doily, and this doily I got, it's this doily. And as you can see, this doily was the one that was in the middle. I just cut this doily out. It's, like one of these that I cut out. And, I got this from, Spare Marbles, Diana. And then this little flower, I don't know if I put one in here. No, I was going to put it in there, but I didn't. I changed my mind. I might still. Who knows? This one is from Nancy Hernandez. She shared little crocheted flowers with me a long time ago. Okay, this little guy right here is from Mamie. She gave me these vintagey type of pieces. And actually, I think this one is from Mamie. Now that I recall. Yeah, these are the vintage pieces that Mamie shared with me. That's right. She shared green ones and she shared orange ones and red ones. And this is from Mamie. And I put a little piece here on her headdress so that it looks like she's got a bandana on. And then this is part of this. So I cut another little piece there. And this part is from Nola Harris, which is part of this black sari. This is the black sari, and then this is part of this, and this is black sari. This is black sari, and then this piece here, okay, the heart is from Shopa. This piece here, I think that one was from Shopa also. Let me look here. Yeah, I think this one was from Shopa, or it was from Bonnie. I can't remember now. Doggone it. I can't remember who that one was from. Either Bonnie or Shopa. Oh, I hope I'm right. Anyway, so that's all on top of this pink fabric, which you can see the pink fabric here. I just laid it down and then cut the little fringes as a background. And then I put my picture and then I put my, you know, doily frame over that. And then I adorned over the doily frame. And then this guy, this was from Mamie here. Beautiful piece here. And I just cut it like in a scallop. Can see that down there. Just cut it in a scallop. I think that's that page. Okay, and then the next page, this is my pocket pages, and I'm just going to put little tiny goodies. And I used, again, this fabric. It was either, I think it's June Angel Pews. It might be my black fabric, or it might be Deb Hendrick, because Deb Hendrick gave me some black fabric. But I laid it, and it's laid it down, and it goes all the way here, all the way. It's a big lace, so I laid it on top of, you can see the doily there, see the doily. And then this was my scarf, and I had made wall hangings for Natasha Scrapbook Corner out of this scarf. And let me see if I could No, I can't pull it. It's on my... Well, here it is. See, it's this kind of scarf. Really cool scarf. Let me... Where's the edge? See, like this? So, all I did was I just folded it in half. Or folded it down on the top. Like that. And then I just laid it down here. And I cut it. So, you have the fringes here. And then I cut these fringes a little bit. And, of course, I, you know... combed it all out so that it looks pretty. And then this is more of my fabric. This was a applique that I got when I was designing for the piece by piece. And then this pretty piece right here was from, oh God, I forgot, Laces and Things or something. She's an eBay store that Pampered Petals shared with us. She sells these little bling kits or fabric applique kits, so that came out of that. And this is my fabric that I got from Rosella. This again is part of this trim that came from the piece by piece when I was designing for them. And then this is my fabric here. So these are just little pockets that I made, and it's kind of a mirror image, but not really, because I made them different, but the pockets are the same. And then this up here, this box trim, was given to me by Amanda, and she's iMandy here on YouTube. She's now doing makeup stuff. And then these are little blings, and these blings I got from Shopa. And I think that's it. Yeah, I think that's it. So little pockets here. Cutesy little pockets. And those are my two last pages. And then this is the back of the book. Got all the little frizzies everywhere. So that's the back of my doily book. And she's a cutesy chunky monkey book. That's what she looks like on the side. And on the bottom. My camera doesn't want to focus. I'm moving too fast, I guess. And then that's what she looks like on the top and on this side. And that's my little book. I hope you like my little gypsy book, and I hope my friend loves it. Again, I use the purple seam binding to tie it together. And this is just, you know, just loose there. I might even put one more here, I think. If I still have purple seam binding, I think I do. Just to make it secure. And that's the back again. So, yeah, that's it. So, again, I do, I made it out of this. I do have these kits available. $10 for two of these, plus shipping. If you're interested, leave your PayPal email in the description below, and I will send you guys an invoice. And yeah, that's it, guys. I hope you liked my little project share, my little book. And I have tons and tons of these available, so I'll be selling those for the next year, because the blanket was huge and I won't use them. I'm making a bunch of books, but I won't use them all. I mean, that blanket was just, I think it was a king blanket, so there's a ton. If you want more, let me know. Okay, anyway, I'm done. This is my cute little gypsy book from my friend, and I hope she loves it. And God bless everyone. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for your thumbs up and your beautiful comments. They always make me smile. Takes me a couple days to answer them if there's you know, just standard comments. But if there's a question, I try to answer them really quickly. Welcome to my new subscribers. And I think that's it. Okay, stay tuned. There's more projects coming. God bless, guys. Bye. Love you guys. Oh, and happy New Year's Day, Eve of New Year's Day. Eve. Okay, bye.